I've had a lot of people ask me recently, mostly on Twitter, you know, if Donald Trump gets convicted of any of the crimes, like assuming a lot more indictments come out from both Georgia and the DOJ, if he gets convicted in New York at the federal level or in Georgia, doesn't that mean he can't run for president? Well, the answer to that is absolutely no. It does not mean that at all. There is nothing in the United States Constitution that prevents a convicted felon from running for office, any office. So if you meet the age and citizenship requirements, you can still run. Like literally, Trump could run a presidential campaign from a prison cell. He could win the election. He could get the title and still be in prison. That's how not thought out our rules are here in the United States. But there's another avenue that people are starting to get concerned about, and I get a lot of questions about this. What about the pardons? Well, luckily this week, Politico actually put out a really great article explaining the multiple different ways that Donald Trump could, in fact, get pardoned for everything he is either being investigated for right now or has already been indicted for. And there's three different ways. The first way, of course, is if we get the federal charges and conviction, President Biden himself could pardon Donald Trump, much like Gerald Ford did for Richard Nixon, much like Jimmy Carter did for the people who avoided the Vietnam draft. But those pardons cost those guys big time. And Biden, I don't think, would really want to pardon Donald Trump. So I think that option we can pretty much say goodbye to. But we'll come back to it in a minute. The other possible pardons would be state-level pardons. So if Trump is convicted in New York, the governor of New York could pardon him from those state crimes and then he's off the hook. But the governor of New York is a Democrat, Kathy Hochul. I don't think Kathy Hochul is going to pardon Donald Trump. So if we get a conviction in New York, I think those are pretty safe charges that are not going to go anywhere. But things get a little weirder down in Georgia. Not just legally, but things are a little bit weirder there. In Georgia, they're controlled by Republicans. They've got a Republican governor, Brian Kemp, so couldn't Brian Kemp pardon Donald Trump for any charges he may be convicted of in the state? Actually, no, because the state of Georgia is a little bit different, a little weirder. And this is actually weird in a good way, because Brian Kemp does not get to pardon people. The state actually has a pardon board made up of people appointed by the Republican governor. But he would have to petition that pardon board, and then that 5-panel board would have to vote on whether or not to pardon him. But he would not even be eligible for a pardon until 5 years after his sentence began. So even if he gets convicted in Georgia, he couldn't immediately apply for a pardon. He'd have to be in jail for 5 years or 5 years of house arrest before they would even hear his case to determine whether or not he gets pardoned. Now, the last potential one, coming back to the federal level, would be a presidential self-pardon, which of course would only apply if Donald Trump made it back to the White House. As it stands, there isn't necessarily any law on the books that prevents a president from pardoning themselves, but it would set up probably a constitutional crisis to a degree. It would go to the Supreme Court. They would end up ruling whether or not a president actually has the ability to do this, and it could dramatically change the way things are done here in the United States in a bad way if that is upheld. A president could break the law all they want and then pardon themselves. That would be a dangerous precedent. That's how you end up with a dictatorship. So yeah, probably not something we want here in the United States. But what about another option? What if it's not Biden in the White House issuing the pardon? And what if it's not Trump in the White House issuing the pardon? What if, God forbid, it's a different Republican? At that point, all bets are off. Because I think any other Republican that wins that White House, unless maybe it's Mitt Romney, they're gonna pardon Donald Trump. So that's pretty much a given. Even Ron DeSantis, who is, you know, getting attacked by Donald Trump every second of every day, I think even he would pardon Donald Trump. So Those are the possibilities. And of course, all of it hinges on whether or not Trump is even convicted of anything and whether he's indicted in Georgia or by the federal grand jury. Those indictments haven't come down yet, and they may not. So there are still far too many unknowns for us to be worrying about all of this stuff just yet. I'm just putting it on your radar, putting it into the ether, putting it into your minds. These are possibilities. So just be prepared.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.